When you first use memory techniques, you start to create your different images and stories, but when you picture them, you make sure that there's detail and they're really clear. So let's take the event images. So when you're first starting out, your pictures, your stories in your head might look something like this, like you actually see it in this much clarity. Well, when you get faster and you're going at a high speed, like you're trying to memorize 30 images in 10 seconds, all you get little blurs, okay? You don't have enough time to fully acknowledge consciously what the picture is. So say something like this. So say if I was going quickly, boom, boom. And so all I feel in my head, so I'm not seeing it, which is hard to explain. So in my head, I'm like, okay, I saw a boat sliding down a hill, like boat hill, you know? I don't know what the boat looks like. I don't know what the hills look like because I was going past them so quickly. But I know there was like a boat and a hill going there in that location, okay? And so when you start to recall the information, that's what you're going for. Now, of course, when you have like, say for this event specifically, you have like two boats in the same thing, you get confused because you just remember feeling a boat. Now, when you have the images with the two boats, let's see if there's anything close. So right here, we have like two plants, right? And so all you might remember is like a plant. And so it's really hard for you to figure out, okay, I didn't really see what the plant was. I just felt it. And so that's why if you have two or more of this of similar images, you get confused and you kind of have to like try to really zone in and remember, okay, do I remember the position of this flower, the boat, you know, whatever it may be? Because you're not going by the visual images anymore. You're going to buy a sense, a feeling of the images that you're seeing. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you have to train more to get to that point, because there's no way you can memorize all of these images in 10 seconds and still see the cookies as clear as day like that. No, it's a blur. You're like, I think it was like a jack-o'-lantern. Okay, got it. Which is true, but it's not cookie form that you're seeing or that you're feeling. You're like, there's some sort of jack-o'-lantern. And that's it. And so you want to get to that point eventually, because that's where you start memorizing a lot of information very quickly, because you're getting a feeling for everything. And you know, at the end of the day, yes, having the visual aspect is a good thing, but the feeling is a different level of being in tune with what you're, you know, creating the different images and stories. It's the feeling of it. So you don't have to waste time trying to like see everything. You're like, oh yeah, I felt this, boom, let's go on. Felt this, boom, let's go on. And so it's a lot faster. I wish I could show you what I'm talking about more clearly, but this is the best because it's not something you can see, it's only something you can feel. So hopefully you get there to that point, you know, especially with memory competition where you're trying to go as quickly as possible. You know, information that you learn from a book or something, you don't really need to feel that information. You really want to make sure you understand it, first of all, but you see your images, because that's gonna be way more complicated than this. Because with these images, all you have to do is recall it, right? With the book, the concepts, whatever you're studying, you might have to apply it in a completely new way, and that's a lot harder than just recalling some images. So yeah, so start filling your images and not just seeing them. Hopefully you enjoy this video, and I'll see you next time.